Hello and welcome to this video. Today I'll show you how to install the custom firmware Luma 3DS on your old 3DS. That means that it works with the old original 3DS, the original 3DS XL and the 2DS. It won't work with any 3DS console that has a new in the name. I've got another video for new 3DS consoles. I'll make an annotation for that, but this one will only work for old 3DS consoles. Oh, and you can enable the subtitles if you don't understand me correctly. So do that if you want. And you'll need internet access for them, so make sure to have internet access. Anyways, I put the SD card of the 3DS into my PC. And we'll have to copy a few files to it. First, we'll have to download the safeb9s installer. Then we can this file. Then we can open it and extract the .bin file to the SD card. Next, we will have to download the boot9 strap, release the actual or the current version. We don't need the NTR or the devkit version, but the normal version. For that, we'll have to create a new folder on the SD card that we call boot9 strap. It has the same name as the file, just without the extension, and then we can put the files there. Then we will have to download the custom firmware itself. That's Luma 3DS. We can download this release. And extract the boot.firm file to the SD card. Make sure that it's in this main directory and not in a subfolder. And last but not least, we can use or we need the homebrew menu. We can copy that here, but make sure that it's called boot.3dsx and not boot3 or something similar, .3dsx. Now we can eject the SD card and continue with the 3DS. Here we are again. We have to open the system settings. Then we have to go to the internet settings. We have to go to the connection settings. Go to the connection that we use to connect to the internet. Change the settings. Go to DNS. Switch this auto-obtain DNS to no. Go into the detailed setup and enter these addresses. I'll write them into the description as well of the video. So enter these addresses to these, go to OK, click on Save, on OK, and perform a connection test. It is possible that this test fails. In that case, you will have to try it again later, because then the servers are down that are used for this exploit, because basically, this exploit circumvents the check of Nintendo that the firmware downloads are correct, and that way we can inject our own firmware update, and for that the firmware update servers, the unofficial ones, have to work. Now we can turn the 3DS off, and we have to keep something in mind when we start it again. For starting, we will have to press the left shoulder button, the right shoulder button, the D-pad up button, and A at the same time. Then we will have to press the power button, and the 3DS will start. It's possible that the exploit fails. In that case, you will have to restart here and press the buttons again and start the 3DS. And we will boot into this update screen. Here we have to press OK, select I accept, press OK, make sure that the 3DS has enough power, and then it will start this updating dialog. We will have to press OK. And now the 3DS will kind of restart, but it should restart to the installer for the cold boot exploit. The cold boot exploit basically executes the custom firmware on runtime so that we don't have to do some additional steps when we start the 3DS to launch the custom firmware. It will be launched directly when we start the 3DS. Now the exploit didn't work, so I'll turn the 3DS off, I press the buttons again, start the firmware update again, and we'll see, or I'll see you, when it worked. This time it worked, so we have to unlock the NAND. We can do that with this button combination on the top screen. Press A, and now it will take a while. It will back up important things, and then we can press A and the 3DS will restart. Here we can configure the settings of the custom firmware. We can enable loading for external firms. That's important if we want to use tools like godmode 9. We can enable game patching, and we can show the NAND or user string in the system settings. You might want to enable this to make sure that you're in the custom firmware, because otherwise there's not really a way to show or to make sure that you are in this custom firmware. And you can always go back to the screen if you press and hold select when you start the 3DS. Anyways, you can press the start button to save the settings, and now the 3DS will boot into the custom firmware. That was it for this tutorial. Thanks for watching. Now you might want to install some CIA files with FBI or install the homebrew launcher CIA. For that, I made a second part, so make sure to check that out if that's what you want. Thanks for watching, see you in the next part, and bye.